Hey everyone, today I'm going to show you how to make this really cute, pretty flying birds animation with Splice Tool. And I'm going to show you a lot of interesting techniques like modeling and sculpting to create this from scratch. So let's get into it. So here we are in Splice. So the first thing we need to do is to click on this plus button to create a cylinder. Alright, so here we have this one, so let's scale it up a little bit so it's bigger like this. So from this one, you can increase the corner radius to make it like an X shape like this. And then let's rotate it a bit. Alright, so if you look at the right panels, you can see this smooth and edit buttons. So click on it to enter this editable mode. And in this mode, you can see from up here, there's a bunch of different modeling and sculpting tools that you can use to modify the shape. For now, let's select the sculpt tool. So in the sculpt tool, there's a bunch of different modes here, but for now, let's select this grab mode. So what it does is you can click and pull out any part of the 3D shape. And then you can zoom in and zoom out to make the impact bigger or smaller, like this. So now I can easily just pull out the tail of the birds like this and adjust this back of the birds. So this is really bring me back to my childhood where I used to play around with like clay toys to create different shapes and different animals. So this tool is really handy to create some kind of a non-structured shape like this. And you can even rotate to a different angle so you can have like a better views of what the shape is looking from different angles. And from here you can continue to adjust the shape the way that you want it to be. Now I'm kind of happy with the shape of the body of the birds here, so let's go with this. So when you're done with this sculpting, you can click on this close button here to go back to the editable view. Alright, so now you can click on this face tool. So now you can select all of the face of this models. So now I'm going to select all of the polygon to create a tail. So let's select here. And then you can just pull it out like this and maybe move it up a little bit. So we can kind of have the tail here. It's already looking pretty close to what we want it to be. Alright, so we can rotate it a little bit. And as you can see here, we're missing some polygons at this part. So you can select this tool, loop cut, to just click here anywhere to add more polygon to the tail. Alright, so this looking good. So next, I'm going to create a mouth for the bird. So let's create another cylinder. So you can hold shift and scale it down a little bit, maybe like this. And then you can click on this dot here to adjust the height. And from the property panel on the right, you can adjust the top and bottoms of the cylinder to create a pointy shape like this. And then we can rotate it and attach it to the main body here. Alright, so it's looking good. So now I'm going to create the eyes. So let's create a sphere. So we have the sphere here, so now I'm going to copy and paste it into the second sphere here. So the first one I'm going to name it eye, and the second one I'm going to name it eyelid. So with the eyelid sphere selected, I'm going to move it up a little bit. And then on the right panel, let's click on this edit mesh. And from here you can select the polygon of the sphere. So I'm going to select maybe like 60% of the polygon and just remove it by hitting delete. And now we have something like this. So we're gonna use this as a eyelid for the eyes. So let's move it down a little bit so it fits to the eyeballs. Alright, so now let's select the eyeball, and on the material tab on the right, you can see the color channel here. We're going to switch it to depth instead. So if you select on this channel, you can see there is a controller here where you can control where the color should start and where it should end. And you can also adjust this on this scale here. So I'm going to move it a little bit. And then let's revert the color by just move the white to the other side like this. So now as you can see, we can have like a little blurry black dot here. And so you can select this handle here to make it sharper like this. So now we have this pupil in the middle of the eye like this, and you can even like make it a little bit bigger like this. Alright, cool. So now I'm going to select everything and then group it into one group, and I'm going to rename it at I. So we're good here. So let's just move it to the bodies. Okay, next we're going to create the wing for the bird. So let's select the pen tool up here, and with this tool you can draw any kind of shape you want in vectors, and then it will automatically just create a 3D shape for you. So my trick for this tool is you can just start with a very basic shape first, and then you can go back to select these dots and then hold option to adjust the angle, so we can have something like this. So once you're done, let's click on this close button to go back to the main views. And from this view, we have the 3D shape of the wings here. And on the right property panels, as you can see, there's a option here where you can adjust the extrusion to make it look thicker like this. And then you can adjust the bevel, increase the bevel here to make it a little bit smoother. So we can have like something like this. So now let's just attach it to the bodies and then duplicate it into the second wing. Alright, so next I'm going to use the same pen tool to draw some hair on top of his head to make it look a little bit more interesting. Alright, so now let's add some material to this bird. So let's select the bodies and switch the color channel to depth. And now we have this really nice gradient here, and you can select here to open this color handles where you can adjust the gradients the way that you want it to be. So let's move it a little bit to the bottoms like this. And then let's adjust the colors of the gradient. So for this point, I'm going to add some kind of bluish gray to it. And on the other points, let's select a orange colors. And then we can add another colors in the middle here. And for this one, I'm gonna go with something a little bit red, like this. And then you can move this handle here to adjust the gradient. Alright, so this looking good, so I'm going to add another layer to this material, and I'm going to go with a Fresnel. So it's going to give you a kind of look like this. So I'm going to click here to adjust the colors. So maybe I'm going to go with something a little bit yellowish. And then let's reduce the intensity to 60. And for the scale, I'm going to go with 1, and then adjust the intensity to 3. So we have something like this. Alright, so it's looking good. So I wanted to add another layer here, and for this one I'm going to select this image, so that we can apply some texture to the material. So I'm going to select this pattern JPEG here where I already prepare. So let's load it here. Currently you don't see anything because we need to adjust the UV setting. So all you have to do is you click here and switch to spherical, and now you can see that the texture is showing on the bird bodies. So next thing we need to do is to go to this blending mode and then select overlay, and now you can see that this texture is being blended to the rest of the materials. Alright, so now all we have to do is to apply material to the rest of the bird. So we're going to apply to this mouth, and gonna give it the same kind of treatments using depth layers. So we have a nice gradient here, and then switch the color to something that match with the bodies, maybe red or orange like this. And then of course, let's add another Fresnel layer here, and then reduce the intensity to 60, and then we have something like this. And then just apply the same process to the wings here. Alright, so the bird is looking good here, so now I'm going to make it look even better with just some environment setting and some lighting as well. So let's click everywhere on the screen, on the empty screen here, so you can adjust the colors of the backgrounds. So I'm going to go with something a little bit blues, green, blue like this. Alright, so now let's add some more light to the scene. So we already have this kind of a default directional light here. All you have to do is to duplicate it and move it to another position as a backlight. So I'm going to move it here. So as you can see, that is kind of balance out the shadows and highlights of the birds and make it look better. So maybe let's move it up here a little bit, move it a little bit closer, and also reduce the intensity a little bit. And then for this one, I'm gonna move it to this direction so it doesn't make it too bright. Alright, so it's looking good here, so I think I'm going to go with this light setup. Alright, so we have the birds ready here to be animated, and then we can add some interaction to it. Alright, so now let's select the wings, and I'm going to make it flapping up and down. So let's go to this right panel here and turn on this stay. So we have two stay here, the base stay and the stay. So for the base stay, I'm going to make it at this angle like this, and then select the stage. And then for this one, I'm going to move it down to these angles. So we have the two stage at the opposite angles like this. Alright, so good. Let's add some event to this. So we're going to go with start, and then for this is correct. So for this stage, yes, select the stay for this one, and then make sure to turn on the cycle and the repeat toggle. And for the duration, I'm going to try for 0.2. so now we have something like this. And now let's do the same for the other wings. And when you're done, you can click on this play button up here to preview it. Okay, so now we have this bird is flying here, so, but it still look a little bit like static. So I wanted to make it feel a little bit more dynamic by just grouping everything that related to the birds into one big group. And then let's name this bird. Alright, so now with this bird group selected, I'm going to add some state to it. So for the base state, we have like this, and then let's select the state and move it up a little bit. So we have this slightly different Y position, and maybe rotate it a little bit for the stay, and now we have something like this. And now let's add some event to this animation. Same thing, but for this one, let's go with 0.5. so we have the bird is moving a little bit, but it's kind of weird because the tail is just staying at the same position the whole time. So let's just adjust a little bit, move it a little bit more, so we have, feels a little bit better now. So you know, just playing around with all of these to come up with a different kind of animation. And the last thing that I want to do here is to also animate these three hair on his head, so make it feel more dynamic. So let's just select one and then apply exactly the same kind of process to what we have done before for the other parts. Alright, so now we have something like this, but the thing is, it's kind of looking a little bit mechanical, if that makes sense. So I wanted to make it feel a little bit more natural by just adding some delay to one of these hair here. So for this one, let's maybe try with 0.2 to see how it's happened. And then the next one, I'm going to add the delay at 0.1. And now let's play. You can see that it feels much better. It's like every part here of the hair is moving at its individual speed, so we can feel like it's more dynamic, it's more lively. So yeah, that's basically it. That's how you create a bird from scratch, and these are just a basic technique, right? You can always feel free to explore different setting, different kind of colors combination to come out with something on your own. For example, here I have another version of the bird. So the difference here is that for the eyes in the lighting channels, instead of using the phone channels at default, I switch it to physical, so it could have like a little bit of like reflection going on here. And I also adjusted the duration of the flapping speed of the wings to 0.1, so we can have like faster flapping speed. So just give it a different look and feels overall. So the bottom line, it was just some small and easy adjustment. You can create various different look and feel for this bird, or you can explore something totally different for your own. So that's the end of my tutorial today. So make sure to check out Splyt.design to try this awesome 3D tool, and I'll see you in the next one.